with large storms and hurricane situations, it's not often that EVs would catch on fire, but we have seen fires, so it's a definite risk that we want to address. Take Hurricane Ian, for instance. In 2022, we had 3,000 to 5,000 electric vehicles submerged in saltwater. Now, 600 of those vehicles were deemed totaled, but only 36 of those vehicles caught on fire. However, when a lithium-ion battery catches on fire, it generates its own heat and its own oxygen. Therefore, it's more difficult to put out. You can't just put water on it and expect it to go out quickly as a gasoline fire, because again, you can't take away the oxygen and just smother the fire. What happens is the salt water or fresh water can get into battery compartments and circuitry. And when this happens, you know that it can short circuit the system and cause sparks and ultimately fire. The salt water is very corrosive, and salt water can eat into circuitry and short circuit batteries very quickly. So you don't want that situation to occur. You don't want to drive through salt water either if you have flooding on the highway and so forth. You want to, limit your exposure to salt water. If there's a storm, a major storm in the forecast, you want to make sure that you look at the manufacturer's recommendations in your owner's manual or online to take your car, if it's safe to do so, and move it to a higher ground or a safe place, especially if you're in any kind of flood zone or you have the smallest chance of having a flood situation. Any vehicle that's been submerged should be considered as if it were in an accident. And you do not want to get in, you do not want to push start, you do not want to drive that vehicle. At the very least, you want to have a tow truck flatbed that vehicle to be at least 50 feet away from any other vehicle or personal items that may be flammable, and you definitely don't want to keep it in any kind of covered storage area. Listen and for any kind of hissing and popping sounds. If you smell smoke or you notice anything unusual, you would want to call your local fire department. When a lithium-ion battery fire occurs in an electric vehicle, they're more difficult to extinguish and they present different challenges to emergency responders that haven't been dealt with in the past. So we need to train our first responders and our second responders on how these fires occur and how to put them out effectively, so that we don't have tow trucks driving down the street with an EV reigniting.